Hey everybody, Trina here. I am a registered nurse. I've been a nurse for 30 years. I've worked in the OR, I've worked in the ER, and I've worked in ICU. And hand washing is priority one when it comes to keeping yourself healthy. Not just through flu season, not just through the cold season, all the time. Hand washing is priority one. So I bet you're gonna learn at least one or two new tips today on how to wash your hands. And those one or two new tips can actually be what saves you from getting sick. I'm gonna teach you how to wash your hands like a surgeon, because surgeons have to spend time scrubbing their hands and making sure they are really clean in order to proceed with surgery. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. But first of all, I'm here in the bathroom and I'm gonna teach you how to use a public bathroom to clean your hands. I'm also gonna teach you how to dry your hands and get out of the bathroom without contaminating your hands. So the first thing you wanna do, if possible, in a public restroom, is notice whether they have a lever or an automatic dryer, because that's gonna depend on what you do. So before you wash your hands, if they have a lever or something that you have to manually use to get the paper out, you're gonna wanna do that before you wash your hands. Because if you touch that lever after you wash your hands, you're gonna be contaminated. So the first thing you're gonna wanna do is make sure you have enough paper before you wash your hands. A little trick is if you need to use something other than your hands because you forget, your elbow works great. It's a little tricky, but it works great at allowing you to push that lever down. So I have done that. The next thing is you want to turn the water on and you want to make sure that your sleeves are up so you can actually get your wrists washed as well. Your wrist can be a place of contamination. So I'm going to pull my sleeves up as much as I can. This is the time of the year to go ring free. Surgeons take their rings off before they do surgery. So when you wash your hands like a surgeon, your hands are ring free. Rings, even just a plain band, is not gonna move completely so that you get to wash the skin underneath it. So that's a place where bacteria, viruses, germs can actually hide. So removing your rings at this time of the year, or flu season, cold season, is actually really beneficial for your health, or even removing them just to wash at least once a day. But I have removed my rings beforehand. Wearing a watch, sometimes you can't always wash, so at least once or twice a day, make sure you remove your watch. Even clean your watch with a little bit of a sanitizing fluid, liquid or something, something to clean it, and then washing underneath that watch. All right, so the main thing is this sink is low enough, but if this sink were higher, a lot of kitchen sinks are countertop height, you wanna make sure that you're not washing your hands so they're like this. So a lot of kitchen sinks, you can wash your hands like this. You want always so your hands are down, facing down. You want all the germs to run down and off your hands, not up your sleeve, right? You don't want all those germs going up your sleeve. So always remember, hands down, germs off, germs to the ground, hands down, even with your kids. A lot of bathroom sinks are okay, but kitchen sinks and sometimes other sinks are high enough that you can actually, without even thinking about it, your hands can be like this, and now the water's running this way. So I'm gonna turn it on. I'm gonna turn it on with my wrist, like that. The underside is probably gonna have less germs on it. Everybody touches it like this. So the underside might actually have less germs, but I just turned it on with my wrist. And then you wanna make sure that you're rinsing or getting your hands wet and your wrists as wet as possible. You also wanna make sure you're using enough soap. So I'm gonna soap it up. I'm gonna teach you how to wash your hands. Okay, normally my hands would be facing down. I would always be washing with the soap with my hands facing the ground down. But for purposes of the video, they're probably not gonna be completely down. But I wanna show you how to get everything. So start up by your wrist and really work your wrist. You wanna make sure that you're moving your wrist around as you're doing this. Why? Because, I'm gonna shut the water off. Because, watch, when I crease it this way, I get creases. When I go this way, you're gonna get creases. You wanna be able to get the germs from all the creases. So make sure when you're washing your wrists and your hands, you're constantly moving your hands. 2 minutes is what I suggest you wash your hands with. 20 minutes is not enough. And if you do my technique, you will spend at least 1 minute washing your hand. Between 1 and 2 minutes is what I recommend. The closer you can get the 2 minutes, the better. All right, so the next thing, washing towards your hand. With your palm, the same thing. You have creases in your palm. So you wanna make sure your palm, you open those creases up. Your knuckles have, when you're like this, your knuckle skin is together and you have creases. Open your knuckles by bending them and washing in between. You wanna wash every finger and get your joints. Okay, so you want your fingers down. You wanna wash with your fingers going down so you can actually open the skin. But then that creates creases here, so then you wanna go the other direction. So you wanna make sure that you're constantly moving your fingers, every finger. When you get to the tip, make sure you're washing your cuticles and your nail, and then you're also getting underneath the nail, cleaning the skin right there underneath your nail. So you wanna do that for every single finger, up and down. Up, so you get all the creases, and down. Up with all the creases up, and then down so the fingers pointed down. And then get all the fingernails as well and under the fingers. If you do that, and it's the friction too, get in between your fingers. Friction is what matters. The temperature of the water doesn't really matter. It doesn't have to be super hot, and it doesn't have to be lukewarm. It can actually be cold as well. It's more the friction of your hand, and that's why doing the friction while you're washing, getting your finger up and down, it's the friction that's gonna help get bugs and germs and things off of your hand. So spend about 2 minutes doing every finger, every joint on your hand. All right, I'm gonna stop and I'm gonna show you how to rinse your hands off, because rinsing your hands off makes a huge difference as well. Same thing, hands pointed down, hands pointed down, hands pointed down. You do not want to wash your hands like this, because look where all those germs are going. And this doesn't matter as much when you're in a sink that's really low, but when you're in a sink that's higher, that makes a difference. For children, keep in mind, for children, you might have to get a stool in the bathroom so that they're not really underneath like that, so that they're high enough so their hands can be down, especially when you are at in the kitchen. So you want to just kind of start up again by your wrist as high as you can, and just massage and work it down off your hand. Hands pointed down. You want all the germs to run off your hand, not down your sleeve. So off your hand, down your sleeve is not a good thing. You want them off your hand. All right, so just rinse your hands. Make sure you feel all the soap is off. Give your hands a good rinse, and then a shake. Shake into the sink, hands down. You really don't want to touch the sink. You don't want to touch anything at this point. You want your hands to stay super clean. So just a little shake. You've already done this. You've already got your towel. You take your towel off. If you do this correctly, you will have your hand protected. This is like a shield. So you're going to wipe your hands like this and just keep wiping your hands. And then fold it around, and then this one kind of just stays in. This ends up being a glove and a mitt. And when your hands are dry enough, that's when you can shut the water off. And then when you go to your door handle, you can actually use this to open the door. The thing is, I carry this with me. If there's no garbage near the door and I can't get out without going back to drop this in the garbage, I carry this out of the bathroom and will drop it at the closest garbage. So that's a key point, is making sure that when you open the door, you're opening it with the handle. All right, so I'm here at the door. I've got my garbage right by. This one happens to be right here. I'm gonna use this to open the door. I'm gonna kick it open and actually open it with my foot. And the garbage is right here in this bathroom, but if it wasn't, I would just carry it with me and drop it outside. So, all right. Stay with me. Got a couple tips on what to do when you're not in the bathroom. Bathroom is not an option, so stay with me.
Thanks for watching. Make sure you subscribe to keep learning how to create your healthy self. See you next time.